AGY means, if we talk about the government commitment, Government of India commitment in Glasgow 2015, we have committed that we will reduce carbon emission around 1 billion ton in 10 years, 2021 to 2030. And another thing that we will increase non-fossil fuel power generation by 500 gigawatt. Third one, will replace 50% fossil fuel in energy with biomass. So 3-4 commitments are there, and as a part of government commitment, paper industry, we cannot keep ourselves apart from that, because paper industry in India, we are among the six major energy user in India. We consume around 7% of the industrial energy use. So our role is very major role in that. So we have to work more and more to honor the government commitment and to save the environment. Because it is not the government commitment, it is our own. Being a responsible citizen, being a responsible corporate industry, we are also committed to save the environment. As an industry, we should promote the farmers, we should educate the farmers that you collect it and we will pay it. So definitely farmers will collect it instead of burning in the farms. Same this rice straw. Every year you may be hearing the news that Delhi pollution is there in November, somewhere December, due to this burning of rice straw. And so still, I think so many years we are talking about that emission in Delhi itself, but no concrete solution is there. Some paper mill, I think Sethia paper mill, they have put one boiler, high pressure boiler, based on this rice straw. Exactly performance I don't know, but definitely it's working. So we should think in that direction also, not the paper industry, the supplier, the boiler manufacturer, they should also think the highly efficient boilers, how it can be given for the biomass. Because till now biomass, we are thinking that okay, we are burning it, whatever we are getting is okay, but it's not like that. To reduce the carbon emission, we have to reduce the fuel consumption. Any boiler, to reduce the fuel consumption, the boiler should be efficient one. That efficiency first, the supplier of that boiler, they have to develop it. If you talk about this chemicals and this one, in chemical, mainly the chlorine and other chemicals which are contributing to greenhouse gas emission, we have to reduce it, we have to minimize it. And we should see the chemicals used for paper making should not contain this compounds, this chlorine base or fluorine base or something like that. Third one, energy, I already covered in this one. Fourth one, water. Definitely water should not be used for paper making. Should not be used. Whatever water we are taking, we should think to 100% recycling it. Though it is not, it's not that much easy, but it is not impossible. Investment is there, recurring cost is there, operating cost is there, but can be done. If we talk about nanny paper, we installed one RO system with evaporation, because RO reject, you will not drain it. In the RO you can recover up to 90-95%, but what about the 5-10% thick filtrate you are getting? So for that we are putting evaporator. Dry chemical water is coming, that for safe handling person will supply to them. So like that, the cost of that water recovered maybe around 100 rupees. But ultimately we have to think, whatever it is there, we have to go. So solutions are there, but again it comes to the barriers. What are the barriers? Barrier one is the nature and location of industry. The paper industry is not very simple. It's not simple because of different type of its size, its product, its raw material mix. So suppose one industry follows some pattern, it's not like that other industry follow that and may get the benefits. Second barrier may be the financial constraint. Definitely it may be there. Third barrier is the training and education. Whether it is our employees, whether it is our stakeholders, as far as this role of ESG in that, actually ESG, environment, social, governance. Nowadays, when the public or government institution, they don't believe on government policies. Because policies are there, but implementation somewhere is, may be there, somewhere may not be there. So what they are doing, they are governing themselves. Suppose you go to the market, customer goes to the market, he will see the paper, whether any smell is there, whether any hazardous chemical is used. Like that, the customer is governing what we have to make.